First, I'll be playing 5 games each for 30 minutes. So before starting the gameplay, let me just set the brightness to 100%. And I have set the phone to airplane mode. Wi-Fi is enabled. I'll also enable GPS and Bluetooth. This is the extreme gaming test. You can see the other options enabled or disabled. And I will also be connecting my USB powered 7.1 channel stereo headphones with the phone. So now I'll remove the charging cable. You can see battery is at 100%. I'll connect the headphones using this dongle, USB to type C. Poco X2 supports it. I'll also enable the LEDs of my headphones. You can see it has started. Volume set to 100%. The display has been set to 60Hz as none of the games supports more than 60fps. So there is no point in setting the display refresh rate to 120Hz. Let's just start PUBG Mobile. Alright, let me just show you my settings. So these are my graphics settings. I'll set the graphics to HD. HDR option is still not available. Frame rate has been set to high. You can see here, if we select the graphics settings as smooth or balanced, ultra frame rate option is present, but I'll select the graphics to HD. Anti-aliasing has been enabled as well. I have disabled the auto adjust graphics option. Let's just start our game. It's a low level account, so we will be playing with bots most probably. Makes it easier to test the performance of our device. So before starting the game, screen temperature is around 32.3 degrees Celsius. And the backside temperature is around 34.5 degrees Celsius. It's a bit difficult to use the virtual controls when the right edge of the phone is being blocked by this dongle. But we just need to test the performance. You can see MIUI game speed turbo mode is enabled. FPS counter shows the game is running at 30-31 FPS. We are in the lobby just waiting for the players to gather. The display of Poco X2 looks gorgeous, I have to say. It's a very big screen. It extends 6.67 inches diagonally. Poco X2 also has a 180Hz touch response rate. So I'll be running PUBG Mobile, GTA San Andreas, Resident Evil 4 using Dolphin Emulator, God of War 2 using Daemon PS2 Pro Emulator, and Asphalt 9. Time to jump. We will also be measuring the temperatures from time to time. Hopefully the phone won't throttle. Getting 30-31 FPS. Alright, finally landed. So even with ultra frame rate option, FPS does not go higher than 40. So I'll just sprint here. Let's check out the FPS. 30 FPS. Okay, someone is nearby. These stereo headphones work very nicely with the phone. I was able to hear the footsteps, the sound coming predominantly from the left direction. Okay, I can hear some gunshots. Let's see where this guy is. I can see someone right in front of me. So I have been playing the game for around 10 minutes now. It's just slightly warm, nothing too extreme. So phone is able to sustain 30 FPS for majority of the gameplay, but I have noticed some slight micro stuttering from time to time. especially during some action. Input response is very good. I haven't noticed any delay. Poco X2 looks to be a very good mid-range gaming device. It comes with Snapdragon 730G processor and also has 6GB of RAM. This is for the base variant. The base variant costs around rupees 16,000 in India. I have done some benchmark tests on it as well. Its CPU throttling performance was decent. The CPU throttled to around 92% of its max performance. I have also run some Daemon PS2 and Dolphin Emulator games. Its processor performance was very similar to Snapdragon 845. And that's a good thing considering its price. Not to mention Poco X2 comes with quad camera setup as well. Its primary sensor is a 64 megapixel Sony IMX686 sensor. It also has an ultra wide lens. It also comes with a depth sensor and a 2 megapixel macro sensor. Okay, there are a lot of people here. Let's check out the FPS. 30-31. Someone is shooting at us. In Xiaomi devices, I've noticed that it takes some considerable time for the battery to drain when it is in the 90-100% range. So I've been playing the game for around 20 minutes. Let me just measure the temperatures. The maximum temperature on the screen side is around 37.2 degrees Celsius. Oh, someone is nearby. I can hear the footsteps. The maximum temperature on the processor side is around 37.8 degrees Celsius. So the temperature is still under 40 degrees Celsius. Even after setting the brightness at 100%, that's really good to see. Alright, only 4 people are remaining now. I have been playing the game for around 25 minutes. I'll drive this vehicle. Getting around 31 FPS. Need to find the last player remaining. It has been around 28 minutes. Alright, finally got him. So we played the game for around 30 minutes. And let me just measure the temperatures. The maximum temperature on the screen side is around 37.1 degrees Celsius. And the maximum temperature on the processor side is around 37.8 degrees Celsius. Yeah. So now I'm going to run Asphalt 9. For Asphalt 9, I'll be using a Bluetooth gamepad. It's AMCAT EVO Gamepad Pro 3. The link for its review will be given in the description. Let me just show you my settings. Visual quality has been set to high quality. Let's just start our game. The graphics look amazing. I've enabled the MIUI GameSpeed Turbo mode and you can see the FPS counter here. FPS counter shows the game is running at 30 FPS and I am not observing any FPS drops. Another short race completed. There are a lot of tracks in this game. You can see the snow clad mountains in the background. The graphics look amazing, I have to say. I'll try to take out some of these races. Poco X2 has a 4500 milliampere hour battery, so it won't be easy to drain this huge battery cell. This is the shockwave. The cliff is literally collapsing. Look at the sunlight effect in the background. Okay, unlock the new car. Got a couple of takedowns. There's a lot of distraction going on. Still, the FPS is around 30. That's good to see. Race complete. So we have been playing Asphalt 9 for around 15 minutes now. Let me just measure the screen temperature. 36.7 degrees Celsius. And on the processor side, it's around 37.6 degrees Celsius. Look at this new track. The graphics look gorgeous. Thunder and lightning in the background. This is a new track. Even here the game is running very nicely. This is the 360 degree flip. We can take out other racers using this. Race completed. Excellent performance by Poco X2. No slowdowns here at all. We have been playing the game for around 25 minutes now, but the performance is still stable. Alright, it's raining in this track. Wow, the graphics look amazing. Just look at these beautiful fields, the flowers. And you can see the FPS as well. FPS is around 31. Yeah, race completed. So for a 30 minute gameplay session of Asphalt 9, let me just measure the temperatures. The maximum temperature on the screen side is around 36.1 degrees Celsius. And the maximum temperature on the processor side is around 37.5 degrees Celsius. So let's just start GTA San Andreas. Let me just show you my graphic settings for GTA San Andreas. Visual effects set to max. Resolution set to 100%. I'll set the draw distance to 100% as well. Shadow set to advanced. Car reflection set to max. Subtitles enabled. Let's just start our game. Let me remind you guys, the brightness is still set at 100%. So phone is able to keep the temperatures at around 37.5 degrees Celsius. Yeah, this cutscene is running very nicely. Let me just show you the FPS counter. So it is running at around 30-31 FPS. Let's just start our game. Yeah, the game has started. This game also supports Android controllers. Okay, need to go to CJ's house. Oh, that was close. Almost crashed into that car. There's the red blip. Alright, I'll just skip the cutscene. That's big smoke. Okay, some gang members attacked us. Need to escape from here. Okay, need to keep up with Ryder. So it's good to see that the game hasn't crashed yet. Poco X2 comes with Android 10. I remember testing this game on Android 9 and it used to crash a lot, but those issues have been fixed now. Oh, they are back again. Alright, this is our house. We can save our game here. There's the cassette. I can use this cassette to save my game. Need to go and see Ryder. Alright, there's a red blip. A phone call. Yeah, that's sweet. I just skipped the call. Another cutscene is playing here. I'll just skip it. Let's just start the mission. So we are at the barber shop. We will be getting a new haircut. I'll go with this one. And just like that, Suiche grew a mustache. We will be robbing this place. Mission complete. Time to go and meet Sweet. So we have been playing the game for around 20 minutes. The maximum temperature on the screen side is around 34.3 degrees Celsius. The maximum temperature on the processor side is around 34.7 degrees Celsius. Everything is under control. And you can see FPS is around 27, 26. There is a slight FPS drop. Now FPS has jumped back up to 30. So even during the melee combat, FPS is around 30, no slowdowns. Alright, need to take out these gang members. Here FPS dropped to around 24. You can see the slowdown. Here FPS dropped to around 25. When there are a lot of cars, it becomes difficult for the phone to sustain 30 FPS. I have noticed that. So for a 30 minutes gameplay session of GTA San Andreas, let me just measure the temperatures. Maximum temperature on the screen side is around 34.7 degrees Celsius. The maximum temperature on the processor side is around 35.5 degrees Celsius.